I've been on my knees and I've been praying loud. Palms getting sweaty, my nerves feeling heavy. Holding back these tears as I see your face. I'm a lucky man, wondering how did I get you. We made it this far, and now we're standing hand in hand. No doubts in my heart that I found the one that's heaven sent. And today is your day. You look beautiful in that dress, baby. Yeah, I fell for an angel. Only two words for me to say. I'ma say it to your face. I do.
Just know I love you, and we in this for the long run.
I do. I'ma say it to your face. I do. I do. I'ma say it to your face. Walking back down the aisle here, wondering where did time go? Where'd it go? We took the thought of a house and a wine picket fence and made it a home.
This is your home, baby.
We made it this far, and now we're standing hand in hand. No doubts in my heart that I found the one that's heaven sent. And today is your day. You look beautiful in that dress, baby. Yeah, I fell for an angel. Only two words for me to say. I'ma say it to your face. I do. I do. I'ma say it to your face. I do. I do. I'ma say it to your face. Daddy gon' be proud of you. Sister gon' be happy for you. All your girls been telling you they knew that we were.
Thank you.
Particular reason, because you mean something to the happy couple, and so we ask your blessings also on this day. To you, our family friends, do you give your love and support to both Duana and Marinisha as they stand poised on the threshold of their new life together in marriage? If so, may we all say, we do.
We do!
I think you heard that from all of them. Let us pray. Holy God, we are ever thankful to witness your love come alive between two individuals. And so God, we affirm your blessing before us now. Help us to celebrate this love now and every day of our lives through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
You may be seated. And so we say hello and welcome again to all those who have traveled near and far to witness these two individuals share their vows. If life has any meaning to us at all, it possesses it because of love. It is that love is that which enshrines and ennobles our human experience. It's the basis for the peace of the family and the peace of all peoples on the earth. And it is said that the greatest gift that is given to us as a humanity is not a love that demands, but rather one that is freely given. And so, after 5 years together, Duana and Veronica, they are, they're giving thanks for the past which brought them to this place, but they also look forward with hope to what the future will bring. We were reminded that years ago, you both opened your hearts to one another, and when you did, you experienced miraculous possibilities, one that we call love. And so it's a testament to all of us that when we open our hearts, not just to love, but also to be loved, miraculous possibilities are always available in our lives. They say that loving someone is a reason to stretch beyond the limits of what is ordinary. It is to look into the soul of your beloved, not only accept what you see, but to celebrate what you see. They say that loving is the ultimate commitment which challenges us to be all that we are meant to be. And you both are announcing to the world that you would be welcome such a challenge. And so, civil marriage is a deeply personal commitment to another human being. We're celebrating the highest ideals of family, of companionship, of intimacy, and the decision whether and whom to marry is always a great one in our lives. It is said that in marriage, two people turn to each other in search of a greater fulfillment than either of them can achieve on their own. And so you both are taking a little bit of a risk by being here today. You're risking what you've already built, your triumphs, any challenges, all the joys. You're willing to risk that for the sake of what yet can be in the form of a marriage. This is also an opportunity for you both to strengthen the common bonds that you have with one another. And so, Duana and Marinisha, remember that happiness in marriage is not something that simply happens. But in marriage, the smallest things are always the biggest things. It's remembering to say, I love you, not only with words, but especially with your hearts and with your lives. It's always speaking with words of appreciation to the other individual. Always remember that as you stand and face the world together, that you can rely upon the faith and love that you've already built in your lives. Remember, you need not look at any sort of imperfections that you might think you have in your relationship. Don't look to others, only look to yourselves and that which God has placed within you. As you stand together and you face the Lord, remember to be patient, be flexible, but also remember to affirm goodness in one another, especially as you do it with yourself. And remember especially, it's not only about marrying the right partner, it's about being the right partner.
Amen.
And so, to you both, marriage requires you to respect the freedom, the individuality, and the dignity of the person. Sometimes we wish to change the other person in our own image, but rather each of you, you stand here today, committing to change yourself, to give yourself more fully to the other person. And so, I ask you now, do you believe that you are called to live your lives together in marriage? If so, please say, we do.
We do.
And you promise to be faithful to the commitments that you make this day, not allowing any other thing to come between the covenants that you make. If so, please say, we do.
We do.
And so, finally, you come now of your own volition, without any sort of coercion whatsoever, or maybe a little. Maybe it's love. You come now with joyful intentions to be joined in marriage. Please say, we do.
We do.
A round of applause for Duana and Mary Nisha, please. Hear these words. I love you, not only for what you are, but what I am when I'm with you. I love you not only for what you've made yourself, but what you're continually making of me. I love you for the part of me that you continually bring out. I love you for putting your hand into my heaped up heart and passing over any frivolous thing that might be there, and for drawing out into the light all the beautiful and radiant things that no one else has looked quite far enough to find. I love you because you've done more than any creed could have done to make me good, and more than any faith could have done to make me happy. You have done it without a touch, without a word, without a sign. You have done it by simply being yourself. And so, Juana, Berenice, enter into today's marriage ceremony, knowing that, yes, you are creating something special in the eyes of God and in the eyes of the law. And then your friends and family members here, all of us as witnesses of this holy covenant, all of us here, we are justly recognizing and celebrating the bonds of love that you have already created in your life. So please remember that there's nothing I or anyone else here can do that can make your relationship as sure as from all the days of your life. Only you, and your integrity and faith, not only with what you speak, but especially what is in your hearts. Remember to rely on that, and rely upon God, and all will be well. And so, as we prepare for sharing the vows, I invite you to please take your hands one to the other.
Let
it be as Miller on the sword.
And so, Duana, repeat after me. I, Duana,
take you, Mary Nisha,
to be my wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poor, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, until death do us part.
And a blessing to your vows this day.
Mary Nisha. I, Mary Nisha, take you, Duana.
I marry you,
to
say you, Duana,
to be my wife.
To be my wife, to have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poor.
For richer or for poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
May God add a blessing to both your vows this day and forevermore. Amen. And so, the happy couple, after they exchanged vows, they also decided to share a gift with one another in the form of rings. And we please have the rings.
Just a little drama, that's all. And so, as you look upon these rings, you will notice that the surface of these rings have no end.
May the love that you declare this day in front of your friends and family members and before God, may your love also never have an end. Dora, as you place that ring on your finger,
repeat after me. I give you this ring,
to wear upon your hand,
as a symbol,
of our love.
With this ring,
I give you my heart.
As you place that on her finger, repeat after me. I give you this ring.
To wear upon your hand.
As a symbol.
As a symbol
of our love.
Of our love.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I give you my heart.
I give you my heart.
Well, the ring's fit, that is always a good sign. And so, if you both hold hands with one another. Savoie, Marisha, you told us that you would love one another. You exchange vows and also exchange rings. And so, let us now invoke the blessing of God that has already been shared in your lives. And so remember, this day and every day, that wherever you are and wherever you go, you are now covered with the love of God each and every day of your life. That love of God surrounds you, and now that love is directly in front of you. May it reflect that glory and that joy each and every day of your lives. Not only do I say it, but we affirm it, that you are now blessed. May God protect you and love you all the days of your life, and all the people we say, amen.
Amen.
And so, Father, Marisha, you indeed have told us that you love one another, and you've shared vows, you've shared rings, and so now, by the blessing of your witnesses, and by the power given to you by the state of Texas, I now pronounce you, wife and wife, you may kiss your bride. Would you please rise as you are able? Present to you, Juana and Marisha, married this day. Give them another round of applause.